We'll look at the application of the Gibbs phase rule, which is here, where what we're interested in is how many variables, how many degrees of freedom do we have in a system. So we're looking at the phase rule for the case there's no chemical reaction. And when we talk about variables, keep in mind we mean intensive variables. This is a very important aspect of the phase rule. Cannot use it to tell us how much of a given phase we have. We can use it to determine if the concentrations, for example, or the mole fractions are fixed when we fix temperature and pressure. So C is the number of components, the number of chemical compounds in the system. So number of components. P is the number of phases. And then the degrees of freedom means the number of variables that we can have control over that are independent. For example, temperature, pressure, mole fractions of a phase. These are the type of variables that we're talking about. Number that we can specify before the system is completely defined. So if we determine that the degrees of freedom is 2, that means we can specify 2 things, for example, temperature and pressure, and then the system is completely defined. So what we want to do is apply this to phase diagram. In this case, it's a case where we're looking at temperature on the y-axis and the weight percent of 10 in a lead 10 system. And so we have liquid at the higher temperatures and then various solid phases. So alpha is a region where indeed tin and lead mix together, uniform alloy. Beta is a similar region that's a high tin content complete mixture. This is a high lead content. This is a region where alpha and the liquid phase are in equilibrium. So we have 2 phases. Any point in here really corresponds to so much of the solid phase and so much of the liquid. Exactly the same now for this region, except the liquid's in equilibrium with the high tin content solid. In this region we have corresponds to 2 solids, so much of the alpha phase and so much of the beta phase. So let's look at some point here in the alpha phase and determine how many degrees of freedom we have. So we're going to look at the alpha phase. So the number of phases is 1. Number of components is 2. And so if we apply phase rule then to this system, we have 2 components, we have 1 phase. It says we have 3 degrees of freedom. So the particular diagram that we're looking at is constant pressure. So for the alpha phase, we have 3 degrees of freedom before all the intensive variables are specified. One of those degrees of freedom is pressure, and we've already specified that in the diagram we're looking at is at a given pressure. So second one would be temperature, and then the third would be, well, let's say the concentration or the weight fraction, the weight percent of 10. So those would be the 3 independent variables. If we pick 200 degrees, we still have a range of concentrations that are possible in the alpha phase. Pick this point at 200 degrees, then we specified a concentration, pressure, and a temperature. Those are 3 degrees of freedom. All intensive variables are now specified. So this is intensive variables that we specified for that system. Let's look at another point in the phase diagram. Let's look at somewhere in this region, alpha plus beta phases. So remember what this corresponds to is a mixture of phase that's rich in lead and this solid phase rich in tin. And a given point determines how much of each of those 2 phases we have. So we'll look at a point in that region of the 2 solid phases and again apply the phase rule. Number of degrees of freedom. Still have 2 components. We now have 2 solid phases. This says we have 2 degrees of freedom. One of those is pressure, which when we specified a particular diagram, that's at a fixed pressure. So we only have 1 more variable. And for example, if we specify temperature, then we fixed all the intensive variables. And so if we look at this diagram and say we're at about 150 degrees, then that specifies concentrations of the alpha phase, concentration of the beta phase. Does not tell us how much of each of those phases we have. For example, if we're at this overall composition, then we have much more of this tin-rich phase than we do of the lead-rich phase. But phase rule doesn't tell us anything about amounts. Phase rule is telling us about intensive variables. We can fix pressure and, for example, temperature or pressure and concentration of a phase, and then everything is fixed. So the phase rule says we have 2 degrees of freedom in this region where there are 2 solid phases in equilibrium.